one. Dear audience, the students and staff of St. Joseph's Convent Girls High School take great pleasure in welcoming you to the annual day celebration.
Success.
You are requested to note the following. Our honorable chief guest and respected guest of honor have arrived. Our school band will now escort our honorable dignitaries to the quadrangle. Gift. Every perfect gift comes from above. These gifts come down from the Father, the creator of the heavenly lights, in whose character there is no change at all. We are here to celebrate our annual function. We welcome you all on behalf of the entire family of St. Joseph's Convent Girls High School. I now request each one of you to stand at attention as the school anthem is being sung.
Thank you.
I now invite Nisa and Sandra to lead us further.
Whether by accident or desire, we are here. Let us make the most of it. Let happiness be our pursuit and spread little sunshine here and there. Isn't it wonderful today?
These beaming and sparkling lights.
The majestic red carpet.
Our revered sisters.
Our eminent chief guests.
Our diligent teachers.
Our dearest parents.
And all the performers who are waiting in the wings with uncontainable enthusiasm. So excited, yet so nervous to make this event a grand success. I am Nisa Naikwadi.
And I am Sandra Nair.
And we are your hosts for the event.
Our school has gotten just a complete facelift.
I'm so excited. I've really missed our annual days.
Missed? Oh yes. How could we even forget that dreaded monster, COVID-19?
Yes, we will never forget it. And probably the stories of it will be passed on from generation to generation.
Oh, those stories will never get old.
First, we were so happy that our exams got cancelled, which hasn't happened in forever. And when we got a message, I bet all of us have danced at this reveal.
We spent days and weeks, aaram se, just whiling away our time, doing absolutely nothing.
We then started our online classes, a new experience for students as well as teachers.
And the stories of our online classes are just marvelous.
Sitting in front of the device with the camera off because we were either having some delicious food, playing video games, talking to someone, or just dozing off to dreamland.
And our tactics during online exams were just stellar and top-notch.
Sitting at home for some manifested their hobbies like baking, while some gained 2 tires off their stomachs.
Then the time went from, wow, this feels so good, to, oh God, I can't stay at home anymore.
Staying at home, we understood the value of education and the value of the people around us. The value of life. Life that is so fragile.
Now we are back in school.
Stronger than ever.
Ready to face the challenges.
And God's ever-present love all around us. Yes, it is annual day and it's time to wrap up all that we have done in the past year.
A year that is about to end and a new one that is about to begin.
Our school, a hub of all the activities and a place where we learn a whole gamut of subjects, from the serious ones right up to the joyful and entertaining ones.
Now it is time to celebrate. And here we are to display to our parents that we can give our best when the best hands mold us and with God's everlasting love all around us to help us grow, not just physically, but mentally, socially and spiritually too.
Under the guidance of the best brains and the most hardworking beings, our dear sisters and teachers have put up this show together for all our proud parents for this very special day,
our annual day 2022, with the theme, Walking Together for a Better World.
God is light. His presence dispels darkness and brightens our lives.
Let us now invoke God's presence in our midst by lighting a lamp.
A spiritual exercise to receive enlightenment from the Eternal One.
I now call upon our Honourable Chief Guest, Mrs. Sunanda Vakare.
Our Guest of Honour, Sister Filda Verghese.
Our Manager, Sister Filmina Vegas.
Our Headmistress, Sister Sheila Simon.
And our Supervisor, Sister Genevieve, to come up and light the samay.
Thank you.
beautiful blend of graceful movements of the body
and powerful expression of heart, mind and soul in meditation.
Let us now begin our program with a prayer dance.
The audience are requested not to clap at the end of the prayer dance.
Meri atma prabhu ko dhanya kaho, mere antarman uske pavitra naam ki stuti karo. Meri atma prabhu ko dhanya kaho aur uska ek bhi vardaan kabhi nahi bulao.
धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, पूरे तन मन तेरे लिए. धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, तेरी स्तुति तहे दिल से गाएंगे सदा. धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, पूरे तन मन तेरे लिए. धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, तेरी स्तुति तहे दिल से गाएंगे सदा. सर्वदा पूरे तन मन तेरे लिए. धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, तेरी स्तुति तहे दिल से गाएंगे सदा. अशांति के हर पल में स्वास्थ्य में अस्वास्थ्य में अशांति के हर पल में हर खुशी हर गम तूने साथ दिया. तेरी आभार से लिए गाएंगे सदा. धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, पूरे तन मन तेरे लिए. धन्यवाद सर्वदा, धन्यवाद सर्वदा, तेरी स्तुति तहे दिल से गाएंगे सदा.
Thank you.
Truly, the prayer dance lifted our inner being to the Almighty.
Music is a great healer,
a powerful medicine to heal our soul
and lift our spirits.
And when it is accompanied with melodious voice, then it is divine.
On this exciting event of the year, our school choir is here to make our evening enchanting with their enthralling welcome song.
Was an orchestral performance. There is no greater pillar of stability than a strong, free, and educated woman.
We are extremely thrilled to have Mrs. Sunanda Vakhare, an eminent personality in the world of education.
She is a virtuous woman with great character and caliber.
An originator of multifarious accomplishments.
Ma'am, you have made our society proud with all the great endeavors you have achieved over time.
Now, I call upon our honorable chief guest, Mrs. Sunanda Vakhare.
Our guest of honor, Sister Filda Varghese.
Our manager, Sister Filmina Vegas.
And our headmistress, Sister Sheila Simon, to come up on the stage.
Now I call upon Isha Doshi to give us a brief introduction about our honorable chief guest.
The seeds of success in every nation are best planted in women and children. A very good evening to our esteemed chief guest, Mrs. Sunanda Vakhare, our guest of honor and provincial superior, Sister Filda Varghese, our manager, Sister Filmina Vegas, headmistress, Sister Sheila Simon, supervisor, Sister Genevieve, Reverend fathers, brothers, sisters, parents, teachers and participants for being with us on this special event of the year, and a warm welcome to you. An investment in knowledge gives the best return in life, so aptly describes our honorable chief guest, Mrs. Sunanda Vakhare, the super efficient education officer of all the secondary schools of Pune district. It is indeed a moment of great joy and proud privilege to have such a brilliant mind with patient heart and gentle hands to lead as our distinguished guest. Mrs. Sunanda Vakhare's life is a message to each one of us that we should not only dream about success, but work for it. Ma'am's certificates of merit speak in volumes about her intellectual capacity and has enabled her to etch a prominent position for herself in our state. To name BSc in Chemistry, MA in Politics, B.Ed, M.Ed, LLB, etc. She has been an extension officer, block education officer, and education officer of several districts of Maharashtra, and is known for the genuine concern that she has for all the schools under her care. Her promptness in immediate action is profusely praised by all the principals, thus spreading ripples of her renown far and wide. Her administrative abilities, mental toughness, problem-solving skills, positivity, endless smiles, etc., make her a multifaceted professional and a graceful genius. She is known for her kindness and understanding nature. Her intellect and dynamic personality has enabled her to win the respect and admiration of everyone with whom she comes in contact. She is a great source of inspiration to all the youngsters who aspire to click the public service examinations, and especially is a role model to girl students. She is a perfect blend of talent, dedication, and discipline, thus making her a superwoman with beauty and brains, and a success icon who enjoys listening to music and reading books. We have always appreciated the warmth and love of your love in our institution. We appreciate your presence in our midst. I now request our headmistress, Sister Sheila, to kindly felicitate our chief guest. Thank you. I now invite Zuveria Sheikh to introduce the guest of honor.
Nothing is more beautiful than a woman who is brave, strong, and emboldened because of who Christ is in her. Perfectly describes our guest of honor. We are delighted to have Sister Dominica Filda Vergis, popularly known as Sister Filda, as our guest of honor. It is truly a time of God's blessing and favor upon us, as we have his beloved servant and a woman after his own heart with us. Sister Filda completed her MA in English Literature from Jalgaon University and accomplished her BEd from Mumbai University. She has been an excellent steward all her life and believed that all her God-given talents and potentials are alone from the Lord, entrusted to her to use in serving him and his people. Being an ardent academician, she started rendering her service to the society by working as an assistant teacher in various places for more than a decade. Later, she worked as a supervisor for 8 years and was promoted as an assistant headmistress for 12 years. Throughout her teaching and administrative career, she was highly successful in inspiring her students, instilling joy for learning in them, tirelessly build their confidence and character, and change their lives forever. Her contribution in mentoring the teachers and motivating them to excel by outlining expectations and helping them becoming excellent educators makes her an epitome of perfection and professionalism. She has also been an assistant provincial, elected and re-elected provincial superior of St. Joseph's province, speaks in volume about her leadership skills and administrative capabilities. It is also a divine confirmation that she is deeply loved, greatly blessed, and highly favored by God. Her life is indeed a message that I can do all things through Jesus Christ who strengthens me. Her unwavering trust and unquestionable faith in the Almighty with unceasing prayers gives her unfathomable strength and makes her spirit uncrushable. She is highly respected even in Christian circles and is known for her consecration and her refusal to compromise with the word of God is indeed commendable. Sister is a charming gardener, a voracious reader, and a seasoned counselor. Her clarity of thoughts, sweetness of speech, her ability to patiently listen and genuinely love without being judgmental makes her an approachable figure, and we admire your cheerful and motherly demeanor, graced with generosity of hands. Truly, one can experience open heavens in her company. We cherish your presence, love, and support to our institution and our sisters. We extend a hearty welcome to you on this momentous occasion of our school's annual day. I request our manager, Sister Filmina Vegas, to felicitate our guest of honor. Thank you.
Every great achievement is the victory of a flaming heart.
Appreciation and recognition are great motivators.
Our school has always been our catalyst in our overall development.
An instrument in applauding and awarding our achievements.
With great pride and delight, we will now announce the names of our toppers.
Now I call upon Siana Lobo to take over.
Good evening to one and all present here. Announcing the general proficiency for the year 2021-2022. I now request our chief guest for today's program, Mrs. Sunanda, to kindly give away the prizes. To begin with, Standard 1A, first, Arnya Deepak Wankhede. Second, Avni Santosh Gunji. And third, Swara Ganesh Bayale. Standard 1B, first, Garima Shailendra Kumar Yadav. Second, Dikshita Kalyan Kurapati. And the third place is shared by Anagha Sachin Lavan and Daraksha Ajaz Sheikh. Standard 1C, the first place goes to Arohi Ashish Koche. Second, Lauren Francis Noronha. And third, Margaret Leo Richard Lazarus. Second A, first, Priya Naresh Thakur. Second, Megha Santosh Pillai. Third, Zara Javed Kazi. Standard 2B, first, Prisha Arun Kumar. Second, Malishka Jackie Mulani. And third, Anam Ibrahim Sheikh. Standard 2C, first, Samika Amay Davri. Second, Zainab Vaseem Sayyad. And third, Gurleen Kaur Gurdyal Singh Hansrani. Standard 3A, the first place goes to Tanvi Dinesh Rane. Second place is shared by Mahi Bhavesh Chawda and Shrija Prakash Ghuge. Third, Sarthaki Satpal Gole. Standard 3B, first, Jovita Dentaline Souza. Second, Aradhya Hriday Mahatre. Third, Riddhi Rahul Pitlelu. Standard 3C, first, Swara Sagar Ratnaparkhi. Second, Amaira Rakesh Malik. And third, Manasvi Vinay Gaute. Standard 4A, the first place is shared by Bhargavi Deepak Sonavne
and Purva Prakash Chaudhary. Second, Dia Sajan Menon. And third, Rucha Praveen Bokil. Standard 4th B, first, Anjali Mahendra Kadwa. Second, Sanskruti Vikram Pawar. And third, Aliza Firoz Pathan. Standard 4th C, first, Ahilya Praveen Kurub. Second, Trupti Ajay Kadam. And third, Azeen Firoz Sheikh. Standard 5th A, first, Nidhi Sandeep Pal. Second, Trisha Satish. And the third place is shared by Aditi Lute and Sonal Shrikanta Patel. Standard 5th B, first, Shreya Mahesh Nikam. Second, Navika Sagar Saturwar. And third, Durva Vinod Pimpalkar. Standard 5th C, first, Advika Praveen Gaikwad. Second, Shaurya Sudhir Sadode. And third, Tanvi Abhishek Babar. Standard 6th A, first, Shine Simpson Dias. Second, Riya Ganesh Avasthe. And the third place is shared by Sanvi Kalyan Kurapati and Tanishka Harshal Lunkad. Standard 6th B, first, Suman Babu Shigula. Second, Drishti Arun Tyagi. Second, Arohi Ravindra Mali. And third, Shravani Nitin Rithe. Standard 7th A, first, Samiksha Nitin Agarwal. Second, Shravya Sandeep Rai. And third, Siddhi Sandeep Chorge. Standard 7th B, first, Japneet Kaur Mankaval Singh Sabharwal. Second, Navjot Kaur Jasbir Singh Badan. And third, Anushka Anand Kamle. Standard 7th C, first, Zuveria Kaleem Sheikh. Second, Renuka Viraj Kate. Third, Tanishka Niladri Saha. Standard 8th A, first, Disha Govind Gavai. Second, Richa Sandesh Adsare. Third, Natalia Siddhartha Ghosh. Standard 8B, 1st, Sienna Bernard Lobo. Second, Isha Ashish Doshi. Third, Kanishka Rajesh Dangi. Standard 8C, 1st, Isha Anup Lunkad. 2nd, Samruddhi Dharmendra Chandratre. 3rd, Samartha Sachin Shinde. Standard 9A, 1st, Aditi Baswani Patil. Second, Sandra Sajesh Nair. Third, Vidya Ashok Napit. Standard 9B, 1st, Bhumika Manjunath Jadav. Second, Shrutika Rajendra Boini. Third, Prutha Tanaji Khomane. Standard 9C, 1st, Denita Dentaline Souza. Second, Purva Rajendra Jagtap. Third, Nisa Imtiaz Naikwadi. Please give them all a big round of applause. Thank you, dear ma'am. I now call upon my friends Nisa and Sandra to lead us forward. Thank you.
Thank you, Sienna.
Now I request our honorable chief guest, Mrs. Sunanda Vakhare, to address us on this memorable occasion.
Good evening to one and all, my dear students, teachers, parents, and all dignitaries on dais. Education gives us knowledge, knowledge gives us confidence, and confidence gives us respect. So education is a key word, a miraculous word which transforms us in a very good human being. That is what our destination and final goal. Education is more than academic achievements. It's all-rounder development of personality, which includes being sporty and competent enough to face what may come in our life. That's why it's an hour of need to give them skill-based education. It's my appeal to all my teachers, please try to be a good friend and a good mom of your students. All you teachers are their second parents, and your school must be like their sweet home. Their biological parents handed their delicate children in your hands to make them not only bright students, but also very good citizens of this country. Children, your performances were really fantabulous performances. I am really very much impressed by your genius presentation. This program is a good reflection of our great Indian culture. Thanks for all those teachers, principal, guides who helped this program as a successful program. Kharatar khup parents इथे समोर आहे जे महाराष्ट्रामधल्या आज एका स्कूलमध्ये या ॲन्युअल डे फंक्शनसाठी जमा झालेले आहेत. डिसेंबर 19ला आपण या फंक्शनसाठी या स्कूलमध्ये आला असाल. त्यानंतर डिसेंबर 20 जेव्हा आला तेव्हा डिसेंबर 20 मध्ये आपण इमॅजिन करत होतो कदाचित डिसेंबर 21 आपला पुन्हा एकदा असाच डिसेंबर 19 सारखा येईल. पण अनफॉर्च्युनेटली आपण डिसेंबर 20 डिसेंबर 21 हा सुद्धा अशाच पद्धतीने गेला होता आपला. पण त्या परमेश्वराची कृपा म्हणावी लागेल, त्या अननोन शक्तीची कृपा म्हणावी लागेल की पुन्हा एकदा आजच्या 2022 डिसेंबरमध्ये पुन्हा एकदा आपण आपल्या मुलांच्या शाळेत आज या ॲन्युअल डे फंक्शनसाठी उपस्थित आहोत. आपली मुलं पुन्हा एकदा या शाळांमध्ये आली आहेत, सगळी मुलं. जेव्हा 2 वर्ष ती आपल्यासोबत होती, घरात होती, तेव्हा आपण अनुभवलं आहे. मुलांसाठी सगळ्यात जास्त कोविड पॅन्डेमिक त्रासदायक ठरला होता आणि पुन्हा एकदा शाळा गजबजल्यात, आपली मुलं पुन्हा एकदा शिकू लागलीत. शाळेमध्ये मुलांच्या सहवासात, शिक्षकांच्या सहवासात ते घडत आहेत. हा एक खूप आनंदी क्षण आपल्यासाठी आहे आणि म्हणूनच आजचं फंक्शन, आजचं ॲन्युअल डे फंक्शन हे निश्चितपणे मागच्या अनेक फंक्शनच्या पेक्षा जास्त काही व्हॅल्यूज घेऊन येणारं फंक्शन आहे, जास्त आनंद देणारं फंक्शन आहे तुम्हाला, आम्हाला आणि आपल्या मुलांनासुद्धा. या शाळेसाठी जे काही ॲकॅडमिक लेवलवर आणि क्वालिटी एज्युकेशनसाठी जे मॅनेजमेंट आणि सर्व सिस्टर्स, सर्व टीचर स्टाफ जे काही मेहनत घेत आहे त्या सर्वांसाठी माझ्याकडून खूप खूप शुभेच्छा. शाळा खूप चांगल्या पद्धतीने पुण्यातली एक अतिशय उच्च अग्रणी स्थानी असणारी स्कूल म्हणून नावलौकिकाला आहे आणि हाच नावलौकिक पुढे असाच चालू राहो आणि शाळेकडून विद्यार्थ्यांना घडवण्याचं जे काम आहे ते अशाच पद्धतीनं सुरू राहावं, शाळेची उत्तरोत्तर प्रगती होत राहावी अशी या ठिकाणी मी शुभेच्छा सर्व शाळा आणि शाळेच्या मॅनेजमेंटला देते आणि आपल्या सर्व पालकांसाठीसुद्धा. पुन्हा एकदा आपण कोविडमधून बाहेर आल्यावर पुन्हा आपले स्वतःचं आर्थिक स्थैर्य आपण पुन्हा जागेवर आणत असताना आपल्या मुलांची मानसिकता ओळखून मुलांनासुद्धा आपण यामध्ये समायोजित करण्यासाठी मदत करत आहात त्यासाठीसुद्धा आपलं खूप खूप अभिनंदन आहे. शाळेच्या या प्रोग्रॅमसाठी आपल्या सगळ्यांना शुभेच्छा देते आणि थांबते. धन्यवाद.
थँक्यू मॅम फॉर एंडोविंग अस विथ युअर वर्ड्स ऑफ विजडम अँड स्पेअरिंग युअर व्हॅल्युएबल टाईम विथ अस.
We now request Shalaka Mahajan to take over.
Good evening, everyone. Announcing the scholarships for the year 2021-22, standard 1st to 9th. Please may I now request our dear sister Filda Vergis to kindly give away the prizes.
Due to some prior commitments, our respected chief guest cannot stay till the end of the program. Thank you for endowing us with your presence.
Scholarship given by ex-teacher Mrs. Joan Sequeira for the best Catholic student of Standard 1 goes to Valerie Dennis Das. Scholarship given in memory of late Mukta Ben Dhoria by Mrs. M.K. Dhoria for a deserving student of Standard 2 goes to Rochelle Vivian Anthony. Mr. C.P. Vergis Scholarship for the Best Catholic Student of Standard 3 goes to Annette Binos Rambical. Scholarship of late Dr. S.W. Fredericks for securing highest in maths of Standard 4 goes to Ahilya Praveen Kurup. She also receives scholarship given by Mr. Pandit Sharma in memory of Bharati Devi for the student securing first place in General Proficiency Standard 4. Scholarship given by Mrs. Sharon Coutinho for securing first place in General Proficiency of Standard 5th goes to Nidhi Sandeep Pal. Scholarship given by the staff of SJC for a deserving student from Standard 5th, Navika Sagar Saturwar. From Standard 6th, Alina Anthony Rosario. And from Standard 7th, Prachi Gautam Vaghmare. Scholarship in memory of late Sister Mary Lucia for the student securing highest in maths of Standard 7th goes to Navjot Kaur Jasbir Singh Badan and Zuveria Kaleem Sheikh. She also receives scholarship given by Mrs. Kamal Konur for the student securing highest in Marathi of Standard 7th along with Vaishnavi Vaibhav Shiravale. Scholarship given by ex-teacher Mrs. Manisha Anand in fond memory of Raina for the student who excelled in value education of Standard 7th goes to Mugdha Sanjay Mahadik. Scholarship in memory of late Mrs. Pushpa Bhatia for the student securing second place in maths of Standard 8th is shared by Isha Ashish Doshi and Janhvi Jagdish Pujari. Scholarship in memory of late Mrs. M. A. Razak for the student securing highest in mathematics of Standard 8th is shared by Aditi Sheshraj Harinkhede and Isha Anuplunkad. Scholarship given in memory of Ms. K. P. Philomena for a deserving student of Standard 9th goes to Vidya Ashok Napit. Scholarship given by ex-teacher Mrs. Bella Manuel for a Catholic student securing highest in science of Standard 9th goes to Danita Dentaline Souza. Scholarship given by ex-teacher Mrs. Vijay Lakshmi Sairaman for the student securing highest in maths of Standard 9th goes to Aditi Baswani Patil. She also receives late Shri Govind Panikkar scholarship given by Mrs. G. K. Pillai for the best student of Standard 9th. A scholarship given by Mr. Anthony Pereira in memory of his late brother, Mr. Ignatius John Pereira, for any two deserving student goes to Angel Eric Gaikwad and Anayata Dheeraj Desai. Scholarship given by Mr. Ajit Kumar in memory of late Shri K. R. Madhavan Pillai for the best sports student of class 9th goes to Anushka Atul Yerunkar. A scholarship given in memory of late Ms. K. P. Philomena by her father Mr. K. T. Paulos for the best sports person in the school goes to Siddhi Tulzaram Gauri. Thank you, dear sister. I now call upon Priyanka Hunugund to announce the SSC scholarships. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Announcing the SSC scholarships for the year 2021-22. I request Sister Philomena to kindly give away the prizes. To begin with, I call upon the stage Mehak Girish Mehta, who receives the following scholarships. Late Mr. Satyavan Bhatia scholarship given by Ms. Rashmi Bhatia for the best mathematics student of SSC. A scholarship awarded to the SSC student who secures highest marks in English given by Mrs. Vatsala Ganesh Iyer in fond memory of her husband, late Mr. Ganesh Iyer. A scholarship given by the PTA to SSC student securing first place at the board examination. In memory of late Shri S.K. Murthy, a scholarship given by Mrs. Malti Narasimhan for the SSC student securing highest at the board examination. A scholarship given in memory of Shri V.S. Darshana Murthy for the student securing highest marks in SSC. A scholarship given in loving memory of late Major G.L. Samuel by his daughters Mrs. Ramola Kurian and Ms. Usha Samuel for a student of Standard 10th who has excelled in English. A scholarship given by Mrs. Fatima Menin Mascarenhas in memory of her father, late Mr. Olivier Fernandez,
for Standard 10 student who secures highest in English, and Dr. Jaimala Singh Memorial Academic Excellence Prize, a scholarship given in memory of late Dr. Jaimala Singh to the student securing highest at the board examination. Congratulations, Mehak. Let's give her a big round of applause. Thank you, Mehak. Now, put your hands together for Pragati Deepak Lunkad, who receives a scholarship given by the PTA to SSC students securing second highest at the board examination, and Dr. Jaimala Singh Memorial Academic Excellence Prize, a scholarship given in memory of late Dr. Jaimala Singh to the student securing second highest at the board examination. Congratulations, Pragati. Next, we have Asma Kaleem Sheikh, who receives the following scholarships. Scholarship given by the PTA to SSC students securing third highest at the board examination. In memory of late Mrs. Sarla Batra and late Mr. B.L. Batra, given by Mrs. Varsha Malik for the student securing third in SSC. Scholarship given by Dr. R.R. Pardeshi for the best science student of Standard 10th. A scholarship given in memory of late Sister Claudia for the student securing highest in science in Standard 10th. Thank you, Asma. A scholarship given in the memory of late Mrs. Margaret Menezes by Mrs. Severin Ray for the best Catholic student of Standard 10th goes to Sharon De Cruz Swami. She also receives a scholarship given by the management of St. Joseph's Convent High School, Khadki, on the occasion of sesquicentennial of foundress Mother Mary Veronica of the Passion for the Catholic student who secures highest in SSC examination. Moving on, a scholarship given by Mrs. Yvonne DeCosta for the best Catholic student of Standard 10th A securing highest at the board examination, Ratnam Simran William. A scholarship given by Mrs. Yvonne DeCosta for the best Catholic student of Standard 10th B securing highest at the board examination, Irene Jitto. A scholarship given by Mrs. Yvonne DeCosta for the best Catholic student of Standard 10th C securing highest at the board examination, Angelina Minos Rambikal. Late Mr. Satyavan Bhatia scholarship given by Ms. Rashmi Bhatia for the best mathematics student of SSC, Avni Pramod Chandak. A scholarship in memory of late Sister Joanna given by Mrs. Rosie Lopez for the student securing highest in social science, Pratiksha Saudagar Mane. Scholarship given by Mrs. Anuradha Mangle for the student securing highest in Marathi in class 10th, Samruddhi Devananda Nikalje. Scholarship given by Mrs. Shamla Nafde for Standard 10 student who secures highest in Hindi, Antara Ritesh Gaikwad. A scholarship given by Dr. P. Balaji Raman in memory of his late mother, Mrs. T. E. Lakshmi Raman, for a deserving student of Standard 10th, Angelina Johnson Hivens. Teresa Vergi scholarship for the student securing highest at the NIOS, Kavin Albal. Scholarship given by Ms. Vaishnavi Iyer in memory of her late father, Mr. K. S. Vaidyanathan, to the best sports student of Standard 10th goes to Mahi Dhansingh Chaudhary. In Mahi's absence, we have her mother, Sarika Chaudhary, who will receive the scholarship. In memory of late Mother Angela, scholarship for the house prefects for their valuable service to the school in the year 2021-22. Head girl, Anagha Prakash Ghewari.
Red House Prefect Tanushree Ganesh Awasthe, Blue House Prefect Simran Kaur Jasbir Singh Badan, Green House Prefect Rati Chitranjan Tiwari, Yellow House Prefect Asma Kaleem Sheikh, Sports Prefect Mansi Rajesh Deshmukh, Catholic Prefect Sharon DeCruz Swami. A special award for our hockey coach for all the services rendered to our school being awarded to Mr. Bhushan Ganesh Dhere. Late Lieutenant Colonel L.S. Narayan Swami EME Scholarship given by Mrs. V. Narayan Swami for the best student goes to Anagha Prakash Gehwari. Let's give a big round of applause to all of them. Now I request Sister Sheila to announce the rolling trophy for the best student given by St. Joseph Province, Pune.
The best rolling trophy goes to Anagha Gehwari. Give her a big hand.
Thank you, dear sisters. Thank you.
Thank you, friends.
Now, I request our dignitaries to take their seats. Excellence in education and fostering the love of learning is the hallmark of our school.
This year has been a very eventful one for all of us. Apart from preparing the children to qualify for purely academic demands, special efforts are always being made to enable them to face the challenges of the competitive world.
It is a matter of great importance to our school that the students who pass out from our portals should carry forward the values they have inherited here, excel in all that they do, and act as role models in society.
SJC is pleased to present to you the annual report of the year 2022-23.
A great saying goes, education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. It's an enduring tradition to take time to pause, turn around, and look at the fruitful year gone by, achieving both the expected and the unexpected, while setting various milestones and then synergizing ourselves to move ahead to face the challenges in the coming year with a positive attitude. It's a matter of importance to us that the students who pass from our portals carry forward the values they have inherited, excel in whatever they do, and be role model in the society. We thank Almighty God for all the blessings bestowed upon us year after year, especially during the academic year 2022-23. St. Joseph's Convent High School, Kirki, has been stepping from one success to the next all through the years since its humble beginning in 1950, and the past year has been no exception. We have done excellently in academics and non-academic areas. At this juncture, I wish to put on record my sincere gratitude to our provincial superior, Sister Filda Varghese, management headed by Sister Philomena Vegas, headmistress Sister Sheila Simon, and all the sisters of the convent, staff, students, and the PTA for your kind support and cooperation. With great pleasure, I present in a nutshell the highlights of the past academic year 2022-23, not forgetting the inevitable COVID-19 challenges and its experiences. The theme for the year 2022-23, as chosen by the Education Committee of the province, is Walking Together for a Better World. Reopening. SGC saw its opening in the physical mode for the academic year 2022-23 on the 15th of June 2022. This year was a challenging one for us. After a gap of over 18 months, all our students were back to school and our teachers had a very tough time in bridging the gap of learning. Today, with great contentment, we can affirm that we have been able to bring our children back to the rhythm of joyful learning. All praise to the dedication and hard work of the teachers, backed by the strong support of the management and headmistress. Retirement and appointment. Speaking of unfailing support, we bid farewell to our beloved Sister Teresa Joseph, who had been a pillar of strength and was resourceful in every manner of her being to both teachers and students. Her stepping up from being a teacher to retiring and as one of the longest serving headmistress of SJC speaks for her efficiency in itself. With gratitude, we appreciate her pioneering in areas of growth and development of the school in terms of introducing the school band, installation of solar panels, interactive boards, initiating students' participation in all activities, including outdoor games, etc., to mention a few. We wish our beloved Sister Teresa a happy and healthy retired life. Stepping in her shoes with a keen sense to carry forward that torch of excellence and success stories is our newly appointed headmistress, Sister Sheila Simon, who priorly was the supervisor of our school. Sister Sheila is a talent house in herself and is known for her passion for singing. Her journey as a headmistress has just taken wings. Another of her noteworthy qualities is her calm demeanor and optimistic approach, which empowers her administrative skills. We wish Sister Sheila God's blessings and strength to shoulder her responsibilities with love, joy, and wisdom. Ladies and gentlemen, here's presenting Sister Sheila Simon, our new headmistress.
Learning gives you creativity. Creativity leads you thinking. Thinking provides you knowledge. Knowledge makes you great, said our late president educationist, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Good evening, respected sisters, fathers, brothers, ladies and gentlemen. We are on the threshold of our 73rd year, and we have good reasons enough to thank God, our Father, for His bountiful blessings and goodness on our school. Next, we thank you, our esteemed parents, members of PTA, and well-wishers for your continuing support and encouragement. On this momentous day, we rededicate ourselves to our service to society at large. Let's look forward to bond our relationship on trust with your cooperation and that of our dedicated and passionate staff. With the reins of office and responsibilities I hold for this institution, I have with me Sister Philomena Vegas, the manager, Sister Mary Genevieve and Sister Steffi Patil, the supervisors for the high school and primary sections respectively. They work tirelessly to nurture every individual's abilities and channel them to progressive growth, thus focusing on the improvement of the individual and society at large. This year, we welcomed a few new staff members. Their presence has amplified our great SJC family. Academic excellence. Excellence is an art won by training and adaptation. We are proud to report that the year 2021-22 batches of class 10 students brought laurels to the school with their excellence results. We achieved 100% results. They are as follows. Number of candidates registered, 197. Number of candidates appeared, 197. Distinction, 92. Grade 1, 81. Grade 2, 20. Pass grade, 4. Total number passed, 197. And the pass percent, 100%. Our merit holders, Meta Mehagirish, stood first scoring 96.40%. Lungat Pragati Deepak stood second scoring 94.80%. Sheikh Asma Kaleem got the third place scoring 94.40%. Hearty congratulations, dear students, for a creditable performance. This was possible only because of God's grace and blessings for the continuous efforts put in by both students and the devoted staff who took extra classes and remedial measures to help and improve the performance of the students. Teachers' enhancement programs. It's the teacher that makes the change, not the mere classroom. We believe in equipping our teachers to prepare students for their future and to update their knowledge both within and out of the classroom. The school arranged an orientation program, several seminars and teacher ability enhancement modules, etc. throughout the year. Regular staff meeting helped to evaluate teachers' quality of performance and to plan for a future with more innovative methods of teaching and learning outcomes. In conclusion, I would like to say, parents should acknowledge that the hallmark of their child's success is wise time management. Children should not misuse their precious time by surfing the net or spending time on social media. In addition to the school environment, the child needs to be nurtured, protected, and given space to grow into independent individuals. Who can best do this? You, as parents, of course. St. Joseph's School is surely a beacon of light showing the way to these young lives. Yet, your role as parents has an obligation to correct them when they are wrong and give them a caring and safe family environment. Dear parents, we at St. Joseph's School need your cooperation, support, expertise and suggestions to progress and reach the pinnacle of success. We owe all our achievement and success to all the pillars of this institution. A committed, supportive management and loyal staff, enthusiastic students, cooperative PTA, and encouraging parents. With such a strong support, we steer this premier institution to fulfill its mission to the cause of educational endeavor and to hold aloft the beacon of knowledge and life. To put all the events at St. Joseph Convent High School in a nutshell, we would say, encourage a child to observe, to explore, to experiment, to probe, to analyze, to confront, and find solutions. Finally, to develop life skills essential to face the future. Our prayer is that our gracious God be pleased to bless our St. Joseph Convent School family so that we can serve society with new hope and vitality, bringing true human values. I'm extremely grateful to each and every one of you has assembled here to witness the events to be held this evening. Your presence will definitely grace the occasion and boost the morale of our students and the guiding faculty members for the further improvement with the perfection in the field of art, sports and culture along with their academic performance. I wish each and every one of you pleasant, colorful and enjoyable evening. Thank you and God bless you. I now hand over the rest of the report presentation to our office bearers, Nisa Naik Wadi and Sandra Nair.
Celebrations and feasts. Life should not only be lived but celebrated. At SJC, we fully celebrate life. And who at SJC should be more celebrated than our dear sisters? In all grandeur, we felicitated the sisters of the school and congregation on Gratitude Day, themed aptly as your thankfulness flows through me. The day was all about making our dear sisters feel loved, appreciated and regarded for all that they do for us. This festivity soon led into the celebration of Teachers Day, wherein working together to the world of knowledge was the theme, followed by the Children's Day with the theme on the journey towards a better world. Thus, we as a family express gratitude and love towards each other in a simple yet compassionate way.
Mass offerings, which included Vyani Day celebrating priests, house feast celebrations, including Our Lady of Mount Carmel's feast, were celebrated with great reverence. Onam and other religious festivals were also celebrated with due respect and honor, thus cherishing the virtue of unity among our students. The completion of 75 glorious years of Independence Day was celebrated with patriotic zeal by hoisting the national flag, followed by the cultural programs. On the occasion of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, an inter-house patriotic singing competition was organized. Our school also participated in an external inter-school patriotic singing competition organized by the Suvartha Foundation. And we are proud to announce that our school bagged the first place for the same.
Activities and competitions. To promote the competitive spirit and bring out the talent and creativity of the students, they are encouraged to participate in various co-curricular activities conducted by the school as well as external organizers. The pre-primary students enthusiastically participated in drawing and English recitation competitions. Activities of dressing up as community helpers, vegetable and thumb printing, rakhi making, diya decorating, germination of a plant, etc. gave the young learners a clarity of many abstract concepts.
The primary students displayed their talents while participating in competitions that included elocution and recitation in both English and the national language of India, fancy dress competition, dance competition, etc. Activities like salad making, dramatization, best out of waste, diya and Christmas decoration and drawing national symbols to commemorate the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav helped the budding artists to showcase their expertise.
Students from the high school actively participated in competitions like inter-house patriotic singing, quiz, rangoli making, Diwali lantern and Christmas decoration making, flag making and poster making. Activities like tree plantation, book exhibition on the account of Reader's Day and Hindi Divas, World Nutrition Day Rally, Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav Rally, Scout and Guides flag ceremony encouraged students' active indulgence. One of our students, Pradnya Nitin Kharat, participated in the science exhibition and won the second position at the taluka level with her model of the ocean cleaner machine deserves a special mention here. Also, Diksha Agrawal earned an illustrious certificate for poster making competition held by Nyan Sagar Foundation.
At SJC, we not only focus upon the intellectual development of our future generation, but also take care of the emotional and behavioral development right from their early ages by inculcating sound moral values, responsibility, and special awareness. To do so, special value-based school assemblies are conducted, bringing out various themes and current issues. the World Mental Health Day, Hindi and Marathi Divas, Reading Day, Advent Season, and celebration of various religious festivals like Onam, Diwali, Christmas, etc. helps us bring out the feeling of oneness among our students.
To assist the school in managing the student body, we have student representatives elected through a prestigious investiture ceremony for both primary and the high school.
Sports, hockey. With great pride and honor, we would like to share the victorious moments of our SJC hockey team, who played and ranked first in the inter-school and district levels, which paved their way to the third position at the state level for the prestigious Nehru Hockey Cup. In ZP matches also, our team played outstandingly well and was declared as the winners of the match series under the disciplined guidance of our hockey coach, Sir Bhushan. On this impressive achievement of our young players, they were felicitated by the current member of Khadki Cantonment Board and President of Pune District for Hockey, Mr. Manish Anand, who distributed jerseys and hockey sticks to all the players of the hockey team.
Basketball. Our school team won first and third places in basketball, which was organized by the SFA organization under the coaching of Sir Mandar. These meritorious wins were possible only because of the support of the management and headmistress under the disciplined guidance of the games coaches and our sports teacher. We also have champions playing various other individual games like karate, taekwondo, kickboxing, gymnastics, boxing, swimming, cycling, chess, malkham, softball, badminton, and marathon. Hearty congratulations to dear champions.
External examinations. Periodical assessments and evaluations are conducted for students and their progress is informed to the parents frequently. Subject enrichment activities are done by students and teachers evaluate the same as the internal assessment. Our students were given the opportunity to participate in various competitive exams organized by the Olympiad Foundation, SpellBee, Scholarship exams for Standard 5 and 8, Rashtrabhasha, iCube, Elementary and Intermediate examinations. These drawing exams conducted by the Government of Maharashtra enable the candidates to secure their future. The active participation of students in all the above mentioned examinations was commendable. One of our students, Maheshwari Chandrakant Landge, topped the Pune district in SpellBee, being awarded with a gold medal.
Picnics and excursions. All work and no play makes Jill a dull girl. The school had organized a 5 days long educational tour come picnic to Goa. Students visited the Spice Garden, churches in Old Goa, Naval Aviation Museums and Aguada Fort. The students also enjoyed an evening at the cruise in Panjim and had some fun time at the beach. All thanks to the school management and the team of Memories Unlimited who created cherishable moments for the picnickers.
Parent-Teacher Association. We have a strong support of our parents, which we cherish every year. The PTA General Body meeting is an occasion to acknowledge their service to the school. The active and willing contribution of the PTA serves as a strong support system to the school. Meetings of the PTA are held quarterly every year to discuss various issues concerning the growth and development of the school.
And to conclude the report of the year 2022-23, which was a spectrum of events, one leading to other in quick succession. We as the SJC family have experienced God's hands in all that this year has led us into. With grateful hearts, we thank God for being the guiding source in us walking together, making our tomorrows more brighter than our today, and thus a future that is grounded and secure. Living by the radical need to change in order to walk together for a better future is definitely going to make us take stride in its glory. Wishing you all a pleasant evening filled with entertainment, brought to you by the Josephites through Viv Lamore, a musical drama.
The world is filled with countless good, loving and compassionate people.
Yet today, many of these wonderful people face reprehensible and unjust sufferings at the hands of their fellow human brothers and sisters.
Now we present before you a skit on the theme
Walking together for a better world.
This is a journey of how a few misfit artists showed the world the power of walking together.
I am Catherine. Please know, I'm Catherine with a K. And this is my story. A story of how I changed my mindset and outlook towards the people around, thus changing their lives and making their world better, just as mine became the best. So, it all happened when,
hey, are you narrating our story?
Well, it's not your story, it's my story.
My story too.
My story as well.
Don't forget me.
Me too.
Well, yes, it truly is a story that would be incomplete without you guys. So, it's our story.
Come on, let's be the audience.
So, it all happened when,
hey, are you narrating your story?
Not again.
Yes, 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 I am narrating our story.
So, it all happened when,
but why are you narrating your story?
Can't somebody please let me narrate the story?
Well, what I wanted to tell you, ma'am, is that I have recorded the whole incident.
What? Really? You captured everything? Everything we said? Everything we did?
Wow, that's amazing!
Well, I am a cameraman and that's what I do the best.
Perfect. Let's see what you've captured.
So let's start with Mandy's vlog.
Another day, another hour, another moment of my rejected life. This is Mandy, the girl, not man. And this is yet another day at the circus. I just finished my show by putting up all those fake smiles. And now I'm back here with no meaning in life, no goals, just dreams.
Yes. Just dreams. Dreams of making a difference.
Showing the world that I can be more than just a joker. Capable of doing great things.
And not being made fun of all the time.
Remember when we were young? How we all loved to dance?
I can dance and sing.
I don't have feet, but my hands and body can work magic.
I can feel the rhythm and
dance away.
I truly feel better when I'm dancing, cause I feel the music vanish my sadness. It truly brings me joy.
Those were the days, you know.
just move your body. Listen to the music, sing oh and oh. Just move those left feet, go ahead, get crazy. Anyone can do it, sing oh and oh. Show the world you got that fire. I feel better when I'm dancing, yeah, yeah. I'm better when I'm dancing, yeah, yeah. And we can do this together. I bet you feel better when you're dancing, yeah, yeah. When you finally let go and you slay that solo, cause you listen to that music.
Chit-chat like this.
Sir, but the show just got over.
Got over, right? And if it, who will bring my coffee? Who will take my dog for a walk, huh? And who will massage my tired and fragile body?
Yes, sir. I will do, sir.
Ah, that's like my boy. You're my good, good, good boy.
Saw that? He treats me just like his dog.
Well, there's nothing we can do. We gotta let people treat us the way they like.
Yep. Let's get to work. Come on, Broom.
Look! What I've found! It is an advertisement.
Wanted dancers for the VVL.
Hand it over. Let me read. Wanted dancers for Viv Lamour, celebrating unity in diversity. Wow!
Why wow? What is it all about?
Don't you know? Viv Lamour, the world's greatest cultural fest happening right here in our country. Celebrities and dignitaries from all around the world will be present and they require dancers for its grand finale.
Can we participate?
It says open for all. Send your resume at this particular website.
I wish I could go there
and show my talent to the world.
Me too. I too want to do something big.
Back to work, guys, or else Mr. Hugmere will eat us alive.
No! I'm done. I'm done wearing this mask. I want to be free.
Free to do what my heart desires.
So, I think we all want to hit that audition, right?
I'm in.
Me too.
Count me in.
Hey, Marco. What say?
Well, I don't want to be treated like a dog for sure.
Let's do this!
कुछ पाने की हो आस आस कोई अरमा हो जो खास खास आशाएं हर कोशिश में हो बार बार करे दरियाओं को आर पार आशाएं तूफानों को चीर के मंजिलों को छीन ले रात रात हो ख्वाहिशों से बात बात आशाएं लेकर सूरज से आग आग गाए जा अपना राग राग आशाएं कुछ ऐसा करके दिखा खुद खुश हो जाए खुदा नहीं कुछ भी नहीं।
Me again. Mandy the girl, not man. And we are at the St. Joseph's ground where the Viv
Lamar.
Yes, yes. That what my friend scholar said will be held, well, about right now.
And this is our chance to prove the world that we are exceptional.
So well, this is us signing out. Wish us luck.
Bye.
I have great hopes on you, Miss Catherine.
Oh, please call me Catherine. Catherine with a K.
Well, yes, Catherine. Better make this the best show the world has ever seen. My life, my reputation, and your job is on stake.
Yes, of course. You can count on me, silly.
You don't silly me, Catherine. We haven't got a film to work on for months now. This whole production set will be shut down if you don't put your head to it.
Sure, sir. I'll put my head and everything I have to put up a good show.
And stick to the theme. I repeat, stick to the theme.
Yeah, whatever. I'll stick to my criterias.
Line up, people. Miss Catherine doesn't have all day. We got your biodatas. Come when your name is called. Senorita!
Senorita, you look gorgeous. You're selected. Next!
Vrindella!
Vrindella? What a funny name! Disqualified! Next!
Vanessa!
Vanessa? I like your name. You're selected. Next!
What kind of selection is this?
She isn't even seeing her talent.
Monica!
That's me.
What? A handicap? Who even let you in here?
But I can dance. I even have a French degree.
Whatever, no handicaps. You people are totally disgusting. Out! Next!
Hey, that's not fair!
Marco!
Marco? Why are you even here? Shouldn't you be at some kid's birthday party dancing for candy?
I am a professional dancer. I can do any dance move. I am a choreographer.
As if that really matters.
That's not fair.
Jack?
Well, Jack, what a fine resume. You can dance, sing, and also play guitar, keyboard.
Yes, sure. I can rock the stage.
But you know, Jack, with all these qualities of yours, what makes you disqualified is that...
Disqualified? Why?
Disqualified because you're dark and black and... Would you look at this? You're the son of a cleaner. You can't even speak good English and you expect to do great things in life? Well, I do need a cleaner out here at the set. You fit the bill, so selected as a cleaner. Next.
Fiona.
You've come here to dance?
Yes, ma'am. And I can even sing well.
You're a total disgrace. I don't want an elephant dancing and breaking my stage. Please go and exercise. The stage and limelight doesn't belong to people like you. Now out! All these good-for-nothing people seem to think no end of themselves.
Mandy!
Miss Catherine, it is such a pleasure to meet you. I cannot wait to show the world that
you're a transgender? Please get out of my sight. You're a loser and you will always be so. Your entire life. Now out!
Another rejection.
That's it, guys. It's time for us to go home.
I guess we are losers.
We shouldn't have dreamt so big.
No one will accept us for who we are.
Now I believe in pain. Let this pain remind me of this cruel world.
My leg, it's bleeding.
Let me help you, sir.
Well, I need a medical personnel working on me right now.
Trust me, sir.
I am a certified male nurse.
Oh, thank goodness. Oh, thank you everyone, but now I need to go.
Here, you can have one of my crutches.
Thank you. Thank you for being so kind.
Let's go.
Hold on. Where are you people going?
We are dancers. We were rejected at the audition. We were rejected for being us.
We were not given a chance to prove ourselves and our talent.
We are a bunch of rejected men and women who nobody wants.
Wait a minute. Did Miss Catherine reject you?
If you are talking about that lady with slag, then yes.
Well, I forgot to introduce myself. I am the director of Viv Lemore Studio. Mr. Edward Christian Ferrero. And I'm so sorry for my assistant's behavior. Viv Lemore means...
Long live love.
Wait, how did you know?
I hold a French degree.
That's amazing. You are a certified nurse. You know foreign language. And you?
I can dance and sing.
I can play any musical instrument. Guitar, keyboard, you name it.
Brilliant. And what about you?
It really doesn't matter. I'm dead.
What? Why do you say so?
Miss Catherine didn't just reject me, but she also killed me with her words. She killed each one of us. You don't need war to kill people. Your words can very well injure and kill. I'm a nobody.
No, you are not. You are one of the top most influencers. You have millions of followers.
Yes. But no one knows the real me. No one knows that I am a transgender. Once they know, they will hate me. And I'll lose the very little dignity I have left in me.
I cannot take this anymore. Viv Lemore stands for love. There is no love. Then there is no meaning of this entire fest. What's happening? Where is the love? Come with me, dears. I will never let injustice be done here, at my very own studio.
What's wrong with the world, mama? People living like they ain't got no mamas. I think the whole world's addicted to the drama. Only attracted to things that'll bring the trauma. Overseas, yeah, we trying to stop terrorism, but we still got terrorists here living in the USA, the big CIA, the Bloods and the Crips and the KKK. But if you only have love for your own race, then you only leave space to discriminate. And to discriminate only generates hate. And when you hate, then you're bound to get irate. Yeah, madness is what you demonstrate. And that's exactly how anger works and operates. Man, you gotta have love just to set it straight. Take control of your mind and meditate. Let your soul gravitate to the love, y'all.
People
y'all.
Killing, people dying, children hurt and you hear them crying. When you practice what you preach, and won't you turn the other cheek? Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning.
Change. New days are strange, is the world insane? If love and peace is so strong, why are the pieces of love that don't belong? Nations dropping bombs, chemical gases filling lungs of little ones with ongoing suffering. As the youth are young, so ask yourself, is the loving really gone? So I could ask myself, really what is going wrong in this world that we living in? People keep on giving in. Maybe
Making wrong decisions, only visions of them dividends. Not respecting each other, denies thy brother. A war's going on, but the reason's undercover. The truth is kept secret, it's swept under the rug. If you never know truth, then you never know love. What's the love, y'all? Come on,
I don't know.
What's the truth, y'all? Come on,
I don't know.
What's the love, y'all?
People killing, people dying, children hurting, even crying. When you practice what you preach, and what you turn the other cheek. Father, 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 help us. Guidance from above. These people got me questioning.
The world on my shoulder. As I'm getting older, your people gets colder. Most of us only care about money making. Selfishness got us following the wrong direction. Wrong information always shown by the media. Negative images is the main criteria. Infecting the young minds faster than bacteria. Kids wanna act like what they see in the cinema. Whatever happened to the values of humanity? Whatever happened to the fairness and equality? Instead of spreading love, we're spreading animosity. Lack of understanding leading us away from unity. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling under. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling down. It's no wonder why sometimes I'm feeling under. Gotta keep my faith alive till love is found. Now ask yourself,
where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love? One word, one word.
We only got
one word, one word.
That's all we got.
One word, one word.
And something's wrong with it.
Yeah.
Something's wrong with it.
Yeah.
Something's wrong with the good word, word. Yeah. We only got
one word, one word.
That's all we got.
One word.
Where is the love?
Where is the love? Where is the love?
Where is the love? The love, the love.
Catherine!
Oh, please, call me Catherine. Catherine with a... what? It's you? What happened to you? You look a handicap.
Enough! Enough of your behavior, Catherine. You have rejected these wonderfully talented men and women on unreasonable grounds.
Don't blame me. Not just me. Everybody, every single person is disgusted with men of such category. No one wants to be their friend. Every single Indian has the same mindset, the same prejudiced thinking, just like me. So please, don't blame me. I'm just another judgmental Indian like them.
Not everyone is perfect. But that doesn't mean that we neglect them. We all have some imperfection in us.
I don't. Others may have, but not me.
Yes, you do, ma'am.
I do?
You're bald!
No! My hair! Don't you label me like that!
I had perfectly walking legs an hour ago, but look, now I'm limping. It isn't right to make fun of others. I feel their pain when I suffer the same way like them. Anything can make a perfect person imperfect.
Blah, blah, blah. I'm perfectly perfect. I'm not like these losers. And you, give me back my wig. You are fired. Out.
And you? You are fired too! Out!
Me? What? But I'm the best of the best, and you cannot do anything without
me! Security!
You will regret this, Mr. Edward! Mark my words! Mark my words!
We'll see to it! Oof. Come on, guys! It's your time to prove to me and the world your worth! I give you a fair chance.
We will prove our worth, sir.
Let our life sing.
unnoticed she knows no limits, she craves attention, she praises an image, she prays to be sculpted by the sculptor. Oh, she don't see the light that's shining deeper than the eyes can find it. Maybe we are made of blind souls. She tries to cover up her pain and cut her woes away, 'cause cover girls don't cry after the face is made. But there's a
You were excellent, every one of you, even the supporting dancers. I have recorded the entire dance. Mandy, what do you say?
What's in your mind, sir?
Post it on all your social networking sites. And this time, reveal your real self.
Hashtag VivLamore.
Thank you, Mr. Edward. Thank you for accepting us for who we are.
For recognizing our talents.
You touched our hearts.
We are truly grateful to you, sir.
You all are more than just dancers. And tomorrow, you will show the world the power of walking together, hand in hand. At the fest, it is not only going to be a dance show. It's going to be something more than ordinary. Extraordinary.
Look! The video is a hit! I've got millions of likes in just minutes now!
That's great! I have got a plan! Come on!
Days later.
Look at the crowd. Wow. Never had an audience as such for so many years now. Mandy and her crew have worked miracles with their performance. I really should honor them in some way. Welcome one and all to the most awaited Viv L'Amour, the celebration of oneness this festive season. This year, we bring to you a Christmas that is totally Indian, by Indians and for Indians. As we see an array of cultures dance together in unity, let us welcome the source of love among us. Watch out for the star.
Trees and stars, gifts and cakes, I'll feel just every-
Christ showed his love for us by giving his life for sinners who did wrong. He loved the sick, the lame, the blind, the young, and the old. He made no distinction in the love he showed. Can we decide to follow his example? Well, coming back to today's Vevlamo specials, I have another show for you. No, it's not a dance show, but a show that is going to change you.
Our world suffers today with war, violence, hatred, and corruption. Do you know the reason for it all?
You,
me,
everybody present here,
and everybody who together make
the world.
We all are the reason why our world is suffering. We hate each other just because they are not perfect. They are different. They have different cultures, different dialects, different lifestyle, and a different thinking. But as the old saying goes, in unity is strength.
I am called fat. People are disgusted of me.
I am called rough. People make fun of me.
I am called poor. People think I am a loser.
I am called a handicap. People disrespect me.
I am called a transgender. People are scared of me.
And I am called a baldy. 'Cause I am bald. But instead of realizing my own weakness, I love labeling others around me. I hurt many with my words. These people here may be called many things. But after all, they are humans.
You all have seen them dance. Along with being excellent dancers, they are all professionals in fields where they were not given an opportunity to excel. And I want to change that. Introducing to you the new crew of Vevlamore Studios. Here's Miss Monica, the brand ambassador of Vevlamore Studios. Mandy, the head of social media marketing. Mr. Jack, the lead musician and musical composer. Mr. Marco, the head of the medical team. Miss Fiona, the head choreographer.
Mr. Edward, when others rejected us, you held our hands and raised us up.
And I hope when I am about to fall, you too will hold my hand so that I don't fall.
Yes, Mr. Edward.
We all will.
You gave us recognition.
You put a smile on our faces.
You raised us up to stand on mountains. You accepted us the way we are.
And now, presenting to you the great men and women who were once rejected and outcast. But nothing stopped them from creating a great name for themselves with the help and support of those who loved them.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, oh, and it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all. We can't go on tending day by day, and someone somewhere will soon make a change. We're all a part of God's great big family. You know love is all we need. We are the world.
We are a variety. We come in different colors, just as the colors of the rainbow. Only love unites. If we cannot unite together, we cannot walk together. So come, let love unite as we walk together towards a better world. For you and me. As a part of the SJC family, I request everyone present here to hold your neighbor's hand and join us as we sing this song together. Hum honge kamyab.
Hum honge kamyab. Hum honge kamyab. Hum honge kamyab. Ek din. Oh, man mein hai vishwas. Pura hai vishwas. Hum honge kamyab. Ek din. Hum chalenge saath saath. Hum chalenge saath saath. Hum chalenge saath saath. Ek din. Oh, man mein hai vishwas. Pura hai vishwas. Hum honge kamyab ek din. Hum honge kamyab ek din. Hum honge kamyab ek din.
Humility is a solid foundation of all virtues.
We now call upon our guest of honor, Sister Filda, to address us on this momentous occasion.
My dear Sister Philomena, the manager of SJC family, Sister Sheila Simon, the headmistress, all the fathers, sisters, teachers, the administrative staff, helpers, parents, benefactors, well-wishers, all those who are associated with the school management, and all present here. Greetings of love, peace, and joy at Christmas. Before I begin, I congratulate the SJC management for their awesome performance. Put your hands together and give them a thunderous applause. Hearty congratulations to you, sisters, teachers, students, and all those who worked behind the scene. I'm very proud of you. Keep it up. Coming to the Christmas message. What is invisible to the human eye is visible to the seeking and searching soul. My dear friends, a strange professor, thinking to have some fun with a small boy, said, "Tell me, my good boy, where God is, and I will give you an apple." The boy quickly looked up at the man and replied, "But uncle, I will give you a barrel of apples if you tell me where God is not." Yes, dear friends, very often we learn life's good lessons from children, as we experience right now. They open our eyes to realities which we tend to ignore. And one of the realities that we tend to ignore is the presence of God in our life. Our main goal in life should be to recognize the presence of God in our life and share this God with others. For God is love. God is good. God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. The true spirit of Christmas is in the togetherness. It's in the thought to which you put into thinking about others. It is a selfless time where we forgive, take stock of what's important, and become better versions of ourselves. Christmas is all giving and sharing rather than only receiving. Our celebration of Christmas should be a reflection of love and selflessness. Christmas is a reminder that each one of us is meant to follow our own star in our life. As I said in the beginning, what is invisible to the human eye is visible to the seeking and searching soul. By following the star of hope, it will bring us to our meeting place with God, which may be unique to us. The spirit of Christmas lies in discovering that nothing is insignificant if only we can place it in perspective and if only we direct ourselves to follow the star of hope. This Christmas season, let us be creative in recognizing the need of others, as we saw in the skit very well displayed. This time, let us all upgrade ourselves into becoming more loving, caring, sharing, more charitable and generous with both gifts and emotions. We all have a Christmas spirit within us that we just have to awaken it. Human beings are God's finest creation and are blessed with intelligence to make choices. We choose the best for us at every moment. Our minds and hearts crave for exciting stuff. Does this Christmas motivate us to change our life to be better human beings? If it has not been so, then we haven't lived this Christmas in our life. What we miss is to look beyond our comfort zone. Sometimes we haven't reached out to people who are all struggling to survive. We have forgotten the children that miss opportunities for life. The old people are longing to break a conversation with us. Conversation with old people, the grandparents, great-grandparents. The prisoners are losing hope. The low-wage earners, the sick, the orphaned, the depressed, and the cheated are discouraged and disappointed. Shouldn't this be our concern? And not just during Christmas, but always. The birth of Jesus is only a reminder for us to look at all these social issues. Let this Christmas bring about a change in our attitude to be cheerful givers. Let it help us to reach out as much as we can. Let our life and actions speak of who we are. Let Christmas bring new change in our lives. Let us be innovative in our lifestyle. Our renewed life should love and care for all. Let's not be stagnant. Let's find new paths to reach out to the needy. Life can take an unexpected turn and things could change completely. This happens sometimes for our good and for the best. My dear friends, the new year 2023 is going to be a fresh start to treasure best of opportunities. There are a lot of events that will unfold in the coming 365 days. It is indeed a unique gift that is wrapped in hope and filled with full of surprises. Though the pandemic waves have subsided, the effect of the unrest situation will be seen in the years to come. Therefore, my wish for you is that you may have someone to cherish, have meaningful work to do, and have things greater than yourself to believe in. May you be strong enough when there are tough times in your life, and that you may love deeply, forgive willingly, laugh heartily, and live gracefully. Let us take a step forward this festive season to love, to share, and to give. May your new year, 2023, be filled with God's presence, peace, and abundant blessings. Thank you. All the very best for your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, sister, for endowing us with your words of wisdom and experience.
Gratitude paints little smiley faces on everything it touches.
Now it is time to thank every noble soul who has strived hard to make this event a memorable one.
I now call upon Anushka Patel to propose the vote of thanks.
Gratitude is a virtue of a noble soul, for it makes us humble and acknowledge the goodness we receive from those around us. Goodness comes from God and God-loving people. God is good all the time, and all the time, God is good. Good evening, honorable chief guest, reverend sisters, honored dignitaries, respected teachers, dear parents, and my lovely friends. I, Anushka Patellu, am blessed to propose the vote of thanks. On behalf of the management, headmistress, staff, and students of St. Joseph Convent High School, Kirki, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to our chief guest, Mrs. Sunanda Vakare, for gracing this occasion. We had an opportunity to hear from you, and it will be a source of inspiration for us in the future events. We are also grateful to our guest of honor, Sister Filda Vergis, for her pearls of wisdom and a short Christmas message. Truly, we are blessed by it. My sincere thanks goes to Sister Filmina Vegas, our manager, for her guidance and assured moral support through all the endeavors. The success of this program is a result of great teamwork. We are truly indebted to our headmistress, Sister Sheila Simon, for her guidance, foresight, administrative skills, and generosity that has helped us achieve great success and reap a rich harvest in this program. We also acknowledge the goodness and supervision of Sister Genevieve, our supervisor, for her wise and vigilant eye for every minute detail and perfection that has helped us in putting up a good program. I place on record the goodness of all the dignitaries of various institutions for your unspoken words of encouragement and silent support. A big thank you to all the teachers for their dedication and tireless efforts. A special appreciation goes to the non-teaching staff for their involvement and willingness to take on the task completion beyond their comfort zone. I am grateful to all the stage setters, sound and light engineers, and photographers for adding color and festivity to this program. I owe my heartfelt gratitude to Father Edwin Vaz for helping us with sound, music, and dialogue recording. A special appreciation to Mr. Solomon Sathe for ranging his voice to the male character in our play. We appreciate the immense contribution, unreserved support, guidance, and feedback of Sister Steffi and Sister Sheelata. Finally, I express my gratitude to all the shining stars of St. Joseph Convent High School for your marvelous performance. You have enlightened us to see good in all human beings, to be sensitive to one another's needs, ensuring that everyone is accepted and appreciated in our society. We will definitely walk hand in hand towards making this world a better place. We are grateful to all the PTA members, parents, and collaborators for your commitment and coordination. May God continue to bless us all. Thank you.
Indeed, we are incredibly grateful. Truly, today's evening was wonderful. We enjoyed the company of our dignitaries, audience, and participants.
I request everyone to stand up for the national anthem. Wish each and every one of you a restful evening and rejuvenating night, and also extend our warm wishes for Christmas and wish you all a blessed and prosperous new year. Good night.
Good night.